His story captured the hearts of so many viewers over the past few days. A teenage boy recovering from the surgery that saved his life. We got such a huge response to Adam Snow's story that we wanted to learn more about his recovery from a last-minute liver transplant and the illness that made him so sick. Channel 11's Tamika Artis just talked to his family and his doctor.
The family is calling this nothing short of a miracle. Just 3 days ago, they made a public and desperate plea for a healthy liver to save their 14-year-old son's life. Less than an hour after our broadcast, their prayers were answered.
Linda Snow may never know the ID of the person whose liver was given to her 14-year-old son, Adam, but she is grateful all the same.
They've given this little boy a life, and he'll eat a good one.
The Butler Intermediate 8th grader was quite active with no history of health problems until a few weeks ago when he was taken to Children's Hospital with what his parents thought was the flu. Their doctors diagnosed him with a rare disease that attacked his liver and given only a few days to live unless a donor could be found.
And all of a sudden, over the course of about 48 hours, he really deteriorated.
But fortunately, the family's pleas on Facebook and on Channel 11 News paid off when a successful match was found just in the nick of time. Took 6 hours for Dr. Cindy to attach Adam's new liver, and within hours he was talking and his ventilator was removed.
He's recovered nicely.
Doctors say the airborne virus that almost cost Adam his life is rare but could attack anyone with a weakened immune system with fatal consequences. After this experience, the Snows plan to encourage others to give the gift of life by becoming organ donors.
There's so many people that still need help. We were just one of the fortunate ones.
Adam is not out of the woods just yet. Doctors say that he will stay here at Children's Hospital for at least the next 3 weeks just to make sure that his body accepts his new liver. But doctors also say that because Adam is so young and that he was in such good health before all of this started, his prognosis is excellent. Reporting from Children's Hospital, I'm Tamika Artis, Channel 11 News.
And days after we posted this story on Facebook, the comments just keep on coming in. Janelle says, prayers sent for Adam, his family, and lastly, the medical staff, that they may have the knowledge to help him win this fight. And Lynette posted, it's amazing. Our best to you, Adam. Hang in there.
How is Adam doing?
Adam's doing very well. He was just extubated, meaning his breathing tube's been removed. And that tells us the liver's working. He's recovered nicely.
Tell us about the surgery and just the dire need of getting the liver when you did. I mean, how dire was the situation?
So acute liver failure is a very rare condition. More times than not, we don't really know the reason. And when they present in this situation, they tend to start to get effects on the brain. When the liver fails, many substances accumulate that actually make the brain hurt quite a bit. And so the risk here is brain swelling. And the progression to brain swelling involves gradual loss of mental function, from confusion to agitation to frank coma. When he came in, or when we really began to, we've been watching him for a few weeks. And all of a sudden, over the course of about 48 hours, he really deteriorated. And he was always ahead of us. We listed him and we thought we had a little bit of time, and then he bordered on coma very shortly. And so in that circumstance, it's commonly believed that one should try to get a liver replaced within a week's period. So he was fortunate to get a good organ. The organ worked, and within 2 days, his breathing tube has been removed.
Wow. I mean, to go from where he was to where he is now and to think that the family thought he had the flu, I mean, what did he have, or where did this virus come from? Do we have any idea?
So as I mentioned, I'd say over half the time we don't know what the reasons are. There are some common reasons, autoimmune disease, Wilson's disease, etc., in this age group. But the bulk of them are unknown. Viruses are thought to be implicated, but again, more times than not, we can't really isolate one.
And again, to think that, again, so any of us could be susceptible.
Yes. I mean,
are there certain age groups or anybody in particular? Because he was a healthy kid.
Any age group. Any age group is susceptible. But fortunately, it's rare. Fortunately, it's a rare problem.
It's pretty scary, though, when you think about that you know, we're all living and breathing and we don't know.
Yes.
Yeah. And again, just talk about how fortunate, and have you ever seen a family do this, first of all, and then to get such a quick response?
Well, it's always nice to have family and the community get together and advocate for organ donation. With that said, I think in this case, I think the system was already at work. So the organ had become available some time ago, and it was literally as the need arose, the organs were already being offered. We just found the right one at the right time for him.
And we will never know who this donor was. I know the family would be anxious to probably say thank you, obviously such a tragic situation for them,
right.
But for this family, it gave life.
They have ways of connecting both donor and recipient families. It's difficult for us to give out names and details just to protect the confidentiality and the privacy of the families involved.
What's his prognosis now?
I'd say very good. Anyone who recovers this quickly is expected to do well. In the short to intermediate term, the issues will be whether his confusion clears up and at what rate it clears up. And so that's something we'll be watching very closely. But all things considered, he looks like someone who'll do very well long term.
It's a miracle. I mean, you're a transplant doctor, and I know the family has to be so grateful for your expertise. But I mean, when you see where he was and where he is now, it's pretty amazing.
It's a miracle for all of us, I think. It's good for all of us to see him do well.
Anything else you just want to say about donors and the importance of that sort of thing?
I think we can never have enough donors. So whatever you all did and whatever the family did is deeply appreciated. And I think the community response has been very good. So, I think all of that is needed to help such patients in need.
Okay. And again, so he's still got some memory issues and kind of a little
more. Yeah, he's still a little sleepy, okay. But he's arousable and he responds to his parents.
So everything should be fine.
We expect it to be.
Okay, good job. Anything else you want to mention that we didn't mention yet, or anything that didn't get out in the media yet?
No, I think you've covered it all.
How long was the surgery?
Probably six and a half hours, somewhere there.
Okay, and they had to fly that liver in, to keep it on ice or something, and then?
Yeah, it's stored in ice between the time that it's retrieved and the time it's transplanted.
Okay, wow.
And that it worked out fine.
That's pretty amazing. Okay.
Well, his grandfather promised him right before he was still able to speak. He told him, if you get out of this, I will buy you a little fishing boat to fish with. Because this kid's out on, the lake and out on a river. We'll go to camp and he'll be out there and we have to yell at him, please get back. It's time to come in.
So, Mom, first of all, you must be so relieved.
Really,
I can just tell you're smiling.
Yep. I'm a happy girl that I have a little boy again, and he doesn't like hearing it, but he's still the baby, so.
How's he doing?
I'm happy to see the ventilator come out. It was bothering him, and I'm happy to see that he's starting to talk. I'm happy to know that he's not in a lot of pain, but he's never been one to say, I'm really not feeling well, so.
How did you get the news, first of all, that there was a donor, and what was your reaction? How'd you find out?
Well, we were still making calls and on computers still. And the doctor, Dr. Cindy, actually came in and pulled us aside and explained the circumstances and said, we're got it, and, sign here, and, do you have any questions? And away he went.
We were
happy. We couldn't believe that he might have a chance now, and, it was just a matter of hours before he was in surgery from when we found out. So,
and of course, you're a little nervous during the surgery.
Nervous.
Which is to be expected. And so
yep.
Now that he's out, he's recovering, and
we were nervous.
Are you still a little nervous?
I'm a little nervous still. Just I think till they tell me, there's not going to be any rejection to the liver, I think I'll continue to be nervous. But I mean, everything they tell me is good now. And before, it was always bad. Every day was, it's not good. And so now I'm still waiting for him to walk in. When they all come in, I'm like, oh no.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't tell me bad.
When something like this happens and you see the outpouring of support from the community, does it kind of change your views on humanity?
It is amazing. Every day is just, I can't believe this. Or, we got some e-cards that came over, and, they hand us a big stack of them, and people from all over the world, Germany and France and, Texas and Florida, and all these people telling a nice little story. And he'll have a lot of interesting days while we're sitting here doing nothing. So
I was going to say, he's going to have some interesting stories to tell people. Just anything else that you want to say? I mean, obviously, I'm sure you want to know who the donor is.
I just want to make sure they know, and hopefully the newscast, I mean, I'm sure they know who they are, and I hope that, you know, that they know that they've given this little boy a life, and he'll lead a good one, and they can be proud of themselves for making a decision like that, because I know it had to be a heartbreak to lose a loved one. And
anything else you want to say about the donor program? I know that Chris had said that, you know, it's just important that people realize that this is a lifesaver, and it's something that he said he might want to even go around the high schools and talk
right.
to kids about when they're
yeah, he's pretty
lessons.
Excited about it. I mean, he was the one that was going to be the donor and was told hours before that he was not able to do that. They needed a whole liver and it wouldn't matter. So he definitely feels that he wants to do something. He's talked about him and Adam going to the different schools, which I think is a great thing to do, because while we were down at Children's, we see so many sad cases, some that are miracles and some that aren't, and a lot of them are. I know there's someone here, I think, that needs like a lung transplant, and they've been waiting for a while. I'm not sure if it's at this hospital, but I did get an email. So there's so many people that still need help. We were just one of the fortunate ones that, you know, whether it was the outcry to the community and just helped it get here a little faster, whatever it was, we're all thankful.
Okay.